Let's get this kettlebell workout started with the hot potato. Placing the kettlebell in a palm of your hand with the handle down. Handle up could possibly hit you in the chin. And then passing the kettlebell back and forth between your palms at a distance you feel comfortable with and safe with. To challenge the core muscles more, we'll lift the leg forward to the side and then heel up to the glute. Approximately 10 repetitions on each leg position and then switch over to the other side. We're warming up. The warm-up is built into the workout. This first exercise, we don't have to be too strict with repetitions. Get that mind-muscle connection. Feel all the muscles from the top of your head right down to the bottom of your feet all activating, getting energized, getting sculpted. Remember to breathe. Bend those knees, get some spring in the body. Great, next exercise. This is an around the body pass. Notice how I'm gripping the kettlebell. If we hold it too close, we could drop the kettlebell. So grabbing on the outside of the handles, passing the kettlebell around the body. Your body shapes the way that you move it. So let's keep the chest up, shoulders back, belly button pulled in towards the spine. Breathe. To activate more core muscles, we can lift the leg up, out to the side, to the back. About 10 repetitions, switch legs. You can do 5 repetitions, 10 repetitions. Again, just warming up, feeling the hands, forearms, elbows, biceps, shoulders, back, core, quadriceps, hamstrings, calves, knees, ankles, toes, all warming up, all getting activated. All of these exercises work upper body, core, lower body. So at the end of this 15 minutes, you'll be burning a lot of calories. Give yourself a posture check. Chest up, shoulders back, belly button in. Face relaxed. I like to either have a poker face or a big smile, but no tension from the neck up. Keep it going. This is a good one. The more you do it, the more time under tension, the better. All right, now we're going to grab the kettlebell in one arm. We're going to turn your toe out and then bring your elbow and your knee together. On this particular day, my shoulders weren't feeling fantastic, a little achy, so I brought the kettlebell in, elbow into the ribs, and performed the exercise this way. If your shoulders are feeling good, you'll get more work, more challenge by flaring the elbow out to the side. Your choice. We're doing 25 repetitions approximately each leg. If you lose your balance, don't worry. Keep going. Your balance will get better. Practice makes perfect. If you need to stop, readjust your feet, your balance, do that and then keep going. When we lift the knee, watch you don't hunch your shoulders forward. Keep your body, your spine long like an arrow shooting. And as you bring the knee and elbow together, pull the belly button inwards. As the elbow and knee come together, exhale like you're breathing out, blowing out a candle. Inhale, exhale. You'll start feeling your energy levels rise now as your body starts to work out. Focus on form. We're almost done. Great. We're going to take a bottoms up grip now. standing with shoulder width, with your feet pointing straight ahead. We're gonna do a slow motion touchdown catch, over the shoulder touchdown catch. So begin by turning, looking up, extending your arms long, catching the football, bring it to your chest, repeating on the other side. To work the core more, for more isolation, let's keep the feet pointing straight ahead. Let's not let the feet rotate. Nothing wrong with that. We are trying to isolate the core by keeping the feet forward. And you'll also add more flexibility training and mobility by keeping the feet forward. Reminder, this is a slow motion movement. Add a stretch. And as you catch that football, blow out the candle. This will help your muscles extend a little bit longer. We've got the energy flowing. Now we get that mind-muscle connection happening. Stretch and strengthen. All right, next exercise. Keep staying in that bottoms up position. We're going to twist and then a halo. Twist and a halo. Twist, bring the kettlebell behind your head, twist to the other side. Now, for more calorie burning and some lower body mobility, let's let the feet move with the motion here. And as you twist, push your hips into the direction that you're moving. Good, once you get the form, let the speed of the motion naturally happen. Burn a little bit more calories. Feeling good, feeling athletic. Anytime you bring the kettlebell behind your head, it flattens the stomach and the body shapes the way that you move it. Sometimes crunches can actually give you a bit of a bubble stomach. The opposite, bring the kettlebell behind the head, will flatten the stomach, similar to a plank. All right, next exercise. We're going to do a one-arm press and a twist. So we turn the hips to the side and then reach up over your head, twist and press. Looking for muscle reach and extension on this one. So even through the toes, lifting up as high as you can, feeling length through the leg, through the core, right out through your arms, reaching up through the sky. Legs, core, arms. Let's switch over to the other side. We're gonna do two sets each arm. First set, you get the feel of the form. Second set, We set it, the blender, to crush. Feel it and then push it. Belly button in, muscle extension. Energy is flowing, muscles are flexible, feeling strong. We're almost at that endorphin release zone. That's it, keep going. Motion is the potion for feeling strong, staying lean, being energetic, springing in your body. If you're staying still, either you use it or you lose it, okay? So get up, start using it. Yes, doing great. Next exercise, this is a balance exercise, lifting one heel up to your glute, taking a bow, coming up, switching the kettlebell into the other hand. So we have the kettlebell pulling you off to the left and then off to the right. by switching hands, you're gonna get the outside of the leg working. And then when you switch, you get the inside of the leg working. This is three-dimensional muscle strengthening. If you feel your balance is challenged too much, put the kettlebell down and do this body weight only. Be patient, give it time, your body will figure it out. And if not today, you'll go to sleep and your body will program your muscles, so the next time you come and do this, you'll be better. The main thing is you don't get frustrated, you just keep doing it. Your body will figure it out. So it's 10 repetitions, left leg, 10 repetitions, right leg. Feel the flow. Feeling strong, feeling energetic. Form is getting better and better. You're moving, you're improving. Great, next exercise. Having good distance on that kettlebell handle. We're gonna do the tick-tock. Great stretch for the back. Great firmer for the core. Sleekifies the core. Watching my movement here, swinging the arm, kettlebell in front of the body, behind the body, letting the ankles move. Start slow, and then your body starts to naturally speed up. Feeling a great stretch through the core, through the back. Might get a few adjustments through the spine. All right, going into our final exercise, the swing blade. Notice how I'm turning my hands across the body. This will avoid the kettlebell from hitting your thigh. We'll start slowly and then build momentum into a full swing. We want to take those muscle breaks off your body. And what I mean by that is tight muscles is like driving your car with the emergency brakes on. Tight muscles rob you of energy and restrict your movement. So we want to take those body breaks off, move full range of motion, have full energy. This is a great exercise to finish off the workout for full maximum calorie burn, full stretch. Let those feet rotate, your hips rotate. Reach up through the arms, breathe. Let the speed naturally happen as your body feels good. We are now in that endorphin release zone, so let it rip. Don't hold back. Now, when we stop, slowly deaccelerate. We don't want to stop abruptly. We're going to go into our final stretch. We're going to do a side bend, placing the kettlebell on the ground, bring the opposite arm, place the back of the hand on your lower back, and turn open. Stretching out the hamstrings, the glutes, the back, the shoulders. Breathe. Let's switch over to the other side. Feel free to hold the stretch a little bit longer or do it twice. Find a comfortable position. Reach the arm up. Be intuitive. I'll be your guide. You go on the exercise adventure. Stretch it out, breathe. If you hold your breath, your muscles get tight. Breathe in, breathe out. You'll feel looser. Great workout. Last stretch, we're gonna reach over your back. Pat yourself on the back. You just did a great Coach Ryan kettlebell workout. See you on the next one.